You know how we go to first class and we learn that 1 plus 2 is 3. Then we go to fifth class and learn that we can make functions. Then we go to the 10th class and learn high math. And then we find out about quantum physics and the whole mathematic stops working. Just because quantum particles want so.
I'm going to talk about the God's mode of living. If you're not a gamer, you...
Oi!
Hello there, I'm Svetlana. And I'm a gamer in the past. Not the shooter type, but all kind of brain games, what I call, for my intellect to get juice for thinking. This is the perspective I am using when I see life. If you're a gamer yourself, you will know what I mean. If not, then maybe it's something new. Game, you can right away, game equals life. So everything I mention in the game is exactly in life. So when we begin some new game, we are introduced over time through a tutorial. Most of the time, certain aspects of the game are introduced to us. We learn about economy, we learn about structures, certain behavior of certain things, parts of the game, especially if it's something more advanced like Civilization or something like Sims or Spore, one of my favorite games. And every time we evolve, it expands our field. We get comfortable, right? On certain level, we expand, we have more. In life, equivalent is when we get introduced to new aspects, new hobby, new skill, new sphere of life, relationship, for example, at some point we get introduced. So every time we begin something new, and most of the time at the beginning, it's not smooth, first kiss, first pimples. It's not smooth because we are going through a tutorial, right? And we don't always win on the first, when we begin. When we get comfortable, we might get introduced to the cheat codes, or we might download the trainer, so-called, for the game, right? Which gives us next level. We're not interested anymore in doing a career, for example, like in Sims. We already know how the bolts work, and we are not interested in sending our Sim, for example, to work every day, to school every day, so that he brings $5 back home, right? Just like in life. So we already know how it works. It's not interesting anymore. So we begin different challenges. For example, we might think, oh, can I accomplish something within the games? We begin tinkering. We begin trying to create different kind of situations. Cheat codes allow us to, for example, give us money. Motherload in Sims. So we don't want to go to work back and forth, we just use the cheat codes. In reality, in life, it might be hope we get inheritance, hope we win a lottery. See, it's like a cheat code, except we think that life does it for us, the outside world, the objective world, right? If you think that you are the reason of everything in you, in your life, you are the cause, right? The reason is in me. Radical subjectivity, you see how it comes here, comes in. You cause the situations. So inheritance, it's not something that happens accidentally, you're lucky. It's for some reason you want something, and as in cheat codes, it materializes for you, see? Because your consciousness creates, has certain structures that materialize around you. Therefore, inheritance is a cheat code, sort of. Next level. When you are already done, you begin installing mods. And you have different modes, customization, right? Like, I don't want my skin to look like this anymore. I want it more realistic. You begin adding new parts created by other creators most of the time. If you use the reason is me again, everything is you, so other people is also you, part of you somehow, something, your reflection, see, as a mirror. So you, yourself, through other people, you begin adding different parts into your life. For example, I don't want to go like this to work. I want to go like this. So you get bike, for example, and you begin motorcycling or something. Or you can do the so-called core modes, which means that the whole behavior is overwritten, right? If you're a gamer again, you know what I'm talking about. You overwrite or you download some kind of mod, which doesn't just colorize something, but it entirely changes the whole behavior of designed game, right? So instead of, say, I don't know, like everyone goes to university and reaches top of career to become a millionaire, and here is another guy who is good at football, and boom, he gets millions, as example, see? It's again, see, a soul, let's call it like this, a soul in the body wants something, and let's change the game. Everyone does it like this, I don't want it like this, I want it much shorter, boom. So you see the similarity that life is like a game, except all of this, what I'm talking about, in life, it's all being unaware. When life just happens, as I said, as objectivity, life just happens and we think that we are lucky or someone else is lucky. But if you accept this thing that we are center of subjective world and everything happens for us, because we want something, not accidentally. Why I'm sharing this information? Because this instrument, the reason is in me, Russian, patch and consciousness, working with your desires, working with your consciousness, it's sort of a conscious mode for your mind, for your consciousness, which allows you to be in what gamers call God's mode of life. The beauty of it is that you do not follow the rules anymore. You don't have to go the track from A to B through tutorials or skipping tutorials. Generations play this game, right? We, from birth till the death, we have multiple tracks, we can go career, we can love, we have all kinds of interesting games to play in real life. And if our financial part is covered, then we might try something else, right? So we don't have to, we using different modes, see? In life, we can play different games. But God's mode is when you're above all of this all, and you don't even need, you don't need to gather knowledge, you don't need to obviously do the financial track, you don't need to do the career because it's an ego, game of ego. You don't have to search for love because you are self-efficient. You don't need to find someone who will love you and who you will love. Because it's, again, it's one of the known tracks of known for humanity. My sentence is broken. All of these are the tracks within the game. Life itself is a box with different tracks. So when you begin your game, you might choose, I want to play in survival mode, right? When everything comes to you and you have extreme situations, I want to do the laugh, etc., right? Or you can go to sandbox, and this is what I'm referring to. In the sandbox, you have everything already available to you. If you're a gamer, you know exactly what I mean. You might... You already have all the puzzles, all the pieces of the puzzles available to you, and you don't have to, you just open and get it. So, as a gamer, how I came to this realization, normal game is not interesting for me. Normally, I tend to always, soon enough, go to the God's mode or cheats or any kind of bigger game because for some reason it's interesting to me. And I know this feeling of frustration sometimes when you made available for yourself everything available to you in the game, and you have all of these features, all of these panels, and you have no idea what is happening, what to do, why, what it's for, right? You just have a bunch, especially the complex ones with difficult, complicated, I don't know, not intuitively, especially if the interface is not very comfortable, like in game, in body. See, interface would be like you know, it's intuitive, you know what to do, you know that fingers, it's intuitive, right? But at certain moments, like in sex, for example, very first sexual experience, it's not intuitive, we have no idea what what to do, that's why it's so awkward. So imagine that you are a child and everything is available to you, money, music, intelligent stuff. It's very frustrating, right? Because you didn't do tutorial, you don't know how to do it. And that's why, see, this God's mode might feel so weird sometimes. Even I, for myself, I noticed that when I work with my blogs, why do I slow down myself? For example, that's how I came to it. Because I don't want to end up in this moment when I have all of this, everything available. Imagine that billions of money are available to you. And this is just one. Imagine that everyone likes you, because when you are on top of energy, everyone likes you. One of reasons why I'm single, because I blocked myself, because I like this, it sparkles. Because you love everyone automatically. You like everyone. Everyone likes you because you're so full of energy. So it's frustrating when people just come to you, you know, people like you, people want to be your friends. It's frustrating. And so you have billions of money. Everyone is wanting to be your friend and wants to just interact with you. They don't even want anything from you. They just want to be near you because you are so given, so happy. They just want your sunlight, see? So, and this only two. And everything is available to you. It's a huge sandbox life and it might be frustrating, see? But the beauty of it is that you get to do anything. And because you don't even have to save the file. Kind of automatically it saves. So you can choose and play a bit of this game, the track, right? Normally, see, when you play it normally, the game, the life, you begin from, you can take academic leave for the university, but then if you didn't come back, you will be kicked out, right? So it doesn't really, you kind of saved your file of education, but you will get kicked out eventually. And it comes with everything, with career. You can't do something. You have to go up all the time. As soon as you stopped, done, right? So sandbox, see, you can, because you don't need to finish the track, because you are free of anything. You don't have to finish any track. With the relationship also, see why it's relationship without relationship, because you are two self-efficient individuals and you meet, you interact, you love. I mean, it's different kind of love, it's a separate topic, but you don't get stick together. You don't learn each other till the latest bone and then get frustrated that something has changed. No, you automatically assume that person will be with you while you want this person to be with you. If person decides to leave, you ask yourself, why do I want person to leave? And one by one, you find reasons, see? So, and you will be surprised that you actually will want this person to leave, and that's why person is leaving. You meet with the person, you get what you need from each other, the experience, the knowledge, the sensations, their feelings, their realizations, insights, and then you part. You're free, each of you, living separate lives, see? in the sandbox called life, you live and you can go any direction. With this single question, what do I want to do in life? And if I want to play the track, that's fine, continue. But if I want to try something else, if I want this God's mode, then why not?
Let everyone who died be alive again.
Adios.
Oh God! Oh God! No! I meant everybody in 10C be alive again. Obviously, not everyone who's died ever. Are you crazy?